Hi, my dear friends, this is K. Rupesh Kumar, State Responsible Tourism Mission Coordinator, Department of Tourism, Government of Kerala. This is my first video about responsible tourism in my YouTube channel. Please subscribe and share my YouTube channel if you like it. Thank you.
Hi, good afternoon, my dear friends. I take this opportunity to present my views about importance of responsible tourism in post-COVID-19 scenario. Responsible tourism, or RT, is an alternative approach evolved against the negative impacts of mass tourism. Responsible tourism concept was there from the end of 1990s onwards. The concept of responsible tourism is about maximizing the benefits for local community and minimizing the negative impacts of tourism. Even if some elements of responsible tourism were practiced at various parts of the world earlier itself, it was not defined clearly till 2002. A proper definition of responsible tourism was given in 2002 at Cape Town Declaration alongside the World Summit on Sustainable Development, which is known as Cape Town Declaration. The Cape Town Declaration has been widely accepted, and that definition became the definition of responsible tourism. Responsible tourism is about using tourism to make better place for people to live in and better place for people to visit, in that order. Responsible tourism has a triple bottom line approach named economic, socio-culture and environmental responsibilities, which are the three pillars of responsible tourism. Basically, responsible tourism requires that operators, hoteliers, governments, local people and tourists take action to make tourism more sustainable. Responsible tourism is about taking responsibility for making tourism sustainable. Let us start with environment responsibility. Tourism is an industry which totally depends on nature and environment. Waterfalls, wildlife, beaches, backwaters, climate of a destination, etc. are our core products in tourism. All these products are not our creations. They are social capitals and gift of nature. So tourism utilizes these geographical features for our business. So without the geographical or environmental assets, tourism industry cannot survive for a long time. Hence, than any other industry, it is the need of tourism industry to protect and preserve the nature and environment. So responsible tourism promotes the usage of natural assets and social capital within the ecological limits, and trying to minimize air, water, land pollutions. And also responsible tourism try to involve local community for the environmental protection. If practiced responsibly, tourism can improve local living standards. But unethical, unscientific, and uncontrolled development of tourism will destabilize the whole community and will create opposition against tourism. This is the reality. It is very difficult to manage tourism business without local support. Not only that, the local community also have the right to getting benefited while their locality and social capital is being marketed. Hence, responsible tourism supports and ensures economic benefits for local community. Cultural clashes between the guest and host communities are one of the worst situations in tourism. Responsible tourism prevents these kind of negative social cultural impacts. RT also can be utilized as a tool for the protection and rejuvenation of local art, craft, festivals, cuisines, games, traditional livelihood, etc. Now you may be thinking that, is it practical to implement responsible tourism in the field level? Yes, it is. Kerala has a successful model to put forth in front of you. We have a clear model of responsible tourism. Before going into the details of the implementation levels, I would like to share a glimpse of the situations which leads Kerala to practice responsible tourism. Till 2007, Kerala tourism industry and local community were like two parallel lines in many destinations. Community did not receive much benefits from tourism in such places, but they had to face the difficulties of unscientific and unethical tourism, unethical practices of tourism. This created agitations and conflicts between the industry and community at various destinations, and Kumaragam faced it at most. So Kerala started its responsible tourism activities from 2007 with a stakeholders discussion called Better Together, mainly to address the concerns raised by the local community. The official launching of responsible tourism initiative in Kerala was on 14th March 2008. And in 2014 March 2008, there was a declaration on responsible tourism that is considered as Kerala Declaration on Responsible Tourism. This was the second international declaration on responsible tourism done as part of the second international conference organized by IZRT International Kerala Tourism. The field level implementation started in 2008 by practicing economic responsibility. The first phase was basically an experiment. Hence, four types of destinations were selected in the pilot phase. You can see here, Kumaragam, Kovalam, Thekkady and Vaithiri are the first four selected destinations for pilot implementation of responsible tourism. Kumaragam, a backwater destination which faced the conflicts and agitations at the topmost level, as I mentioned earlier. Hence, government decided to include Kumaragam as the first destination for its implement. That means Kumaragam selected as one of the pilot destination for the implementation of responsible tourism in the pilot phase. Kovalam, the world-renowned beach destination of Kerala, this destination was selected to explore the new products and potentials of a beach destination with the involvement of host community. Thekkady, the famous wildlife destination of Kerala, was selected to find out how RT can be practiced in a wildlife destination. Vaithiri, a hill station in Wayanad district with spice plantations and beautiful forests. The place is famous for its diverse traditions of the ethnic indigenous communities. While starting responsible tourism, first phase, it was an upcoming destination. Hence, this destination was selected to develop it as a responsible tourism destination. You can see the other three destinations which are selected as part of responsible tourism for the second phase implementation. Before going that, I would like to explain more about responsible tourism activities we had done in the first phase. Four types of implementation strategies were experimented the first for selected destinations at Kumaragam. We conducted a detailed field study about the to find out the field realities. Farming groups were formed. They were linked with tourism industry. Then there were some conflict about pricing and quality of the local products. A pricing committee as well as a quality assurance committee were formed to address such issues. Good practices were copied to the other destinations, and slowly a system has been developed. During 2009, socioculture responsibility also has been started practicing at destination on pilot basis. As part of socioculture responsibility, village life experience tour packages were formed and started operating it. Cultural groups were formed and they started performing the cultural activities for the guests. By assuming that the development system will sustain by itself, the government had withdrawn the supporting mechanism of for responsible tourism implementation on 2010 June, but the system did not sustain. It proved that the field level implementation of responsible tourism requires an institutional level support and monitoring system. Hence, in 2011, government relaunched responsible tourism initiative as the second phase. The selected destinations you can see from the slide, Ampalavel, Baikal and Kumbalangi, were the three more destinations selected by the government of Kerala for the implementation of responsible tourism on 2011 as part of the second phase of responsible tourism implementation. In 2017, government had analyzed the RT activities of Kerala, and government decided to develop RT into a wider space and form responsible tourism mission under the direct control of direct tourism government of Kerala. This is basically the third phase of responsible tourism in Kerala. This model created a far-reaching impact in tourism sector of Kerala, both for local community and industry. The tourists visiting Kerala also experiencing the change. Now, responsible tourism is the tagline of Kerala tourism. Now, we have a question that, what will be the importance of responsible tourism in post-COVID-19 scenario? I think the world will decisively move towards responsible tourism in post-COVID-19 scenario. Of course, you will have a question that, why we are raising such an argument? I think we cannot expect international travel in immediate future, because the travel bans might be extended to some more time. And of course, there will be a fear about coronavirus also. So we cannot expect large number of tourists in near future. Since the restrictions due to social distancing will persist for some more time, crowding at destinations will be prevented, and people will move towards less crowded destinations. This will be a reality. And of course, the possibilities of economic crisis will also make people to keep away from luxurious travel and luxurious facilities. So I believe that travel is a basic human desire, and the urge to travel will never end. So we have a hope that in between the fear of coronavirus, also people will not lose their travel passion, but there might be changes in choices. And we expect that there will be a boost in rural tourism. Village or rural tourism activities, domestic travel and experience travel. There will be a boost in exclusive packages. There will be a boost in wellness and health tourism activities. Of course, there will be a boost in responsible Ayurveda and packages for immunity improvement. Of course, promotion of local art and games will be another model for upcoming tour packages. And of course, there will be more awareness about cleanliness and hygiene in post-COVID-19 tourism scenario. I'm not trying to explain more about Kerala's beauty. Kerala is very famous for tourism, and we have a brand name, as all of you know. Kerala is considered as the God's own country. We have diverse geographical settings like tranquil beaches, stunning backwaters, majestic hill stations, and wide range of biodiversity, waterfalls. We have lush greenery and unique experiences like Ayurveda treatments, exotic art forms, captivating culture, warm hospitality, and we are well connected with India and other parts of India and abroad. The place is easily accessible and well connected with within and other part of India. The state is already a popular destination. There are a lot of conventional sightseeing packages. So, hence the state is already popular destination, but here we are not talking about the conventional sightseeing packages. I am not trying to explain more about the conventional packages of Kerala, because all of you are well aware about the conventional packages of Kerala. We are discussing the importance of responsible tourism and how it is effectively implemented in Kerala. Without the support of local community, it is not easy to run tourism business. This is the reality. For the protection of nature and environment, culture and heritage, and to give a peaceful experience to tourists, local support for tourism is essential. From our experience, we learned that proper implementation of responsible tourism can ensure 100% community support and involvement in tourism. You can see the benefits of responsible tourism in the slide, like women empowerment, complementing relation between tourism industry and community, real-time experiences for the guest, etc. You can see the Kerala model responsible tourism from this slide. Kerala model responsible tourism proved that responsible tourism can change confrontation in destinations to cooperation. This is the reality of the implementation. This is the clear result of responsible tourism implementation in Kerala. Before RT implementation in Kerala, there were, as I mentioned earlier, that there were a lot of conflicts and disagreements between tourism industry and local community, including local self-governments. And after the implementation of responsible tourism, majority of the issues already resolved, and there is a clear, good and healthy relation in between tourism industry and the local people. You can see the result of responsible tourism implementation in Kerala. Before starting responsible tourism in Kerala, very low benefits from tourism to local community and negative socio-cultural and environmental impacts. Local tourism industry and local community conflicts were there. Local panchayats had a feel that they totally sidelined from tourism development, and strong indicators of unsustainable destination. So local agitation against unethical tourism development before the implementation of responsible tourism. After implementation of responsible tourism, there is a clear good rapport with tourism industry and local community. At the same, there is a clear rapport with tourism industry and local panchayat. Local communities arrived decision-making power in tourism. New methodology adopted for tourism resource mapping through local communities' involvement. Measures are taken for a sustainable tourism development without harming the environment. There are a lot of innovative and unique tourism products derived from the implementation of responsible tourism. Now, you can see the slides of the possibilities of responsible tourism or possibilities through responsible tourism mission. We have different major responsible tourism destinations. Kumaragam, Vayanad, Bekal and Kovalam, Kozhikode, Kannur, Ponnani and Thekkady are considering as our major responsible tourism destinations. As part of responsible tourism initiative, we identified or we developed some unique destinations as part of responsible tourism missions, new projects like Pepper and Model Arti Villages. Pepper is our major projects. Pepper means people's participation for participatory planning and empowerment through responsible tourism. As part of this initiative, we will conduct special tourism Grama Sabhas in selected local self-governments, and then we will conduct group discussions and focus group discussions, field level studies about tourism potentials. We will select beneficiaries for training. We will start units of responsible tourism mission, and then we will conduct tourism resource mapping. Then we will identify tourism products, and then we will restructure the mass tourism packages. This is the way of implementation of Pepper project. You can see there are different unexplored destinations or unique destinations or virgin destinations identified as part of this initiative. Around 48 destinations identified. You can see from you can see the destination from the slides. We have different tour packages, and all of them are the result of the incorporation of our three pillars of responsible tourism. Means economic, social, culture and environment responsibility parts are incorporated in these packages. We have village life experience packages. You can see the products of village life experience packages. As part of village life experience packages, we have identified some traditional livelihood activities and converted them as community-based tourism products. Economic and socio-cultural responsibilities are incorporated in village life experience packages. We have full day and half day village life experience packages. Around 90 packages, 140 packages are available in various parts of Kerala. We offer cultural experience packages. As part of this initiative, guests will have the chance to experience various cultural activities, various traditional cultural activities of Kerala. Here also the same economic responsibility practiced along with socio-cultural responsibility. We have festival tour packages. We already identified 14,000 festivals, unique festivals of Kerala, and packaged them as part of our festival calendar. And now we are marketing as part of all these festivals as our festival tour package. Here also economic responsibility while giving focus to social culture part. We have fishing expeditions. These packages offers various types of fishing experiences from traditional to modern techniques. It is the part of our socio-cultural and economic responsibility activities. We have carbon neutral packages. This is a part of environmental responsibility. We have roving shikara packages, roving country boat packages. We have village work programs. We have cycling or electric cycling packages. All these packages are packages give focus to environmental responsibility while practicing economic responsibility. We have a new package named Experience Ethnic Bar Local Cuisine. As part of this initiative, we have 2,800 registered families. All of them are FSSA registered units, and they are trained and certified units. The guests will have the chance to experience the traditional or ethnic cuisine of Kerala through this package. You can see, this is our very new initiative. Learning experiences. This is the latest initiative to address the challenges of post-COVID tourism. We cannot expect, as I mentioned earlier, we cannot expect large number of tourists in coming future. So we design such packages to expand the length of stay of a guest. Here also economic responsibility practiced along with social cultural responsibilities. We have farm tourism packages. We have 6,000 registered farmers as part of responsible tourism activities. Majority of them are directly linked with tourism industry and local for local procurement. Besides that, they are incorporated with farm tourism activities. Economic, socio-culture, and environmental aspects are incorporated, are practiced through these packages. We have experiential stay options. As part of our experiential stay options, different types of accommodation facilities can be experienced through these packages. Traditional style of accommodation facilities are offered in these packages along with tent stays. These packages are also an example for economic, socio-cultural, and environmental responsibilities practices. Now, you can see the strength of our mission. We are not tour operators. We are the part of Department of Tourism, Government of Kerala. We are working as in a facilitator role. We have 18,000 registered units. Majority of them are, we have individual units, group units, and family units. We are working with the local self-governments and network with all LSGs in Kerala. We have 1,000 trained registered and trained resource persons. We are networked with 580 hotels and resorts. Around 400 homestays and farmstays are part of RT mission. And we are networked with more than 1,000 national and international tour operators. We are working with all major national and international travel and tourism organizations like WTM, ITB, ICRT International, and ICRT India. As part of economic responsibility, 10,000 registered units are there, and 50,000 beneficiaries are working with us as part of economic responsibility. 5,000 people already trained under economic responsibility in between 2 years. Around 22 crores of Indian rupees earned by these units in between 2 years. As part of socio-cultural responsibility, we have 5,000 registered units, 27,000 beneficiaries, 2,800 people trained under socio-cultural responsibility, and 10 crores of Indian rupees earned by the local community as part of this initiative. As part of environmental responsibility, we have various interventions for waste management and waste-free tourism destinations. We already started RT classification for houseboats, Ayurveda centers, and homestays. Responsible tourism classification for hotels and resorts are in progress. And there are a lot of serious interventions to health and hygiene practices. Afforestation destinations and properties. We are focusing. It is a serious initiative. And as part of this initiative, we are promoting Miyawaki method of afforestation. We are promoting alternative eco-friendly products for plastic in tourism sector. And we already signed agreement with around 800 hotels and resorts as part of plastic free declaration, and they are considering us our plastic free accommodation units. The same practices are trying to implement through implementing in destinations also. As part of this initiative, we have 1,000 registered units for eco-friendly products and 23,000 beneficiaries are working with Responsible Tourism Mission as part of our environmental responsibility. You can see some the photos of our units. After the formation of Responsible Tourism Mission itself, we have received 7 awards, including 4 international and 3 national awards. We already bagged WTM WTM Responsible Tourism Award. We already bagged Pacific Asia Travel Association Gold Award for Women Empowerment Tourism. And you can see the details of our awards. More than these awards, we care for the achievements of Kerala tourism through Responsible Tourism. Awards came to us as a result of these achievements. RT Mission gave a new face to Kerala tourism. And RT Mission developed a wide variety of tourism products. And Responsible Tourism Mission created or generated 1 lakh new tourists in between 2 years. The majority of them are satisfied guests. There is no complaints till now. We are well connected with local self-governments, and these local self-governments are well connected with tourism. Of course, there is an enhancement of local employment and local procurement for tourism. And we have a serious level initiative for women empowerment. Around 40,000 units of Responsible Tourism Mission are headed by women leaders. As part of this initiative, we can ensure 100% community support for tourism. And Responsible Tourism created good rapport with in between community and industry. Through Responsible Tourism Mission, Kerala Tourism has also started to support other states for implementation in their places. For example, we already signed an agreement with Madhya Pradesh Tourism Board for the implementation of Responsible Tourism in their region. And Kerala Responsible Tourism Mission activities or Kerala Responsible Tourism activities became world model for responsible tourism practices, and it is a well-defined system derived through practice from grassroots. I think all of you you got an idea about responsible tourism activities of Kerala. At the same time, I hope that you will get an idea about the importance of responsible tourism in post-COVID-19 scenario.